51. Mind monkey in vain uses a thousand tricks. Feudal water and fire makes it hard to smelt demons. We were telling you about the great sage, equal to heaven, who fled in defeat, empty-handed. He went to the back of the Golden Helmet Mountain, and as he sat down, big drops of tears fell from his eyes. Oh master! He cried. I had hopes that you and I, since Buddha's grace had both kindness and peace, would find same youth, same life as my lasting wish. To live, to work, to seek the same release. With same will, same mercy to show our spirits fruit. To reason and think the same, our minds truly one. To know and behold the same open way. I knew not I would lose the staff of my will. How could I prosper with empty hands and feet? After lamenting like this for a long time, the great sage thought to himself. That monster spirit recognized me. When we were fighting just now, I remember him paying me the compliment, truly someone worthy to cause havoc in heaven. Judging from this, I can't imagine that he is a fiend of this mortal world. He has to be some evil star of heaven who descended to earth out of longing for the world. I wonder what sort of demon he really is and where he dropped down from. I'll have to go to the region above to make an investigation. Thus it was that pilgrim, using the mind to question the mind, deliberated with himself and thereby gained control of himself. Leaping up, he mounted the auspicious cloud and went straight before the South Heaven Gate. As he raised his head, he was suddenly met by the Devaraja Virupaksha, who bowed low and said to him, "Where is the great sage going? I must have an audience with the Jade Emperor." Said Pilgrim, "What are you doing here?" Virupaksha said, "Today, it's my turn to patrol the South Heaven Gate." Hardly had he finished speaking when Ma, Zhao, Wen, and Guan, the four Grand Marshals, all appeared and greeted Pilgrim, saying, "Great Sage, we are sorry that we have not come to meet you. Please have some tea with us." "But I'm busy," said Pilgrim, whereupon he took leave of Virupaksha and the four Grand Marshals and went inside the South Heaven Gate. When he arrived before the Hall of Divine Mists, he ran into Zhang Daoling, Immortal Ge, Xu Jingyang, Qiu Hongzhi, the six officers of the Southern Dipper, and the seven heads of the Northern Dipper. Meeting Pilgrim before the hall, they all raised their heads to greet him, saying, "Why has the great sage come here?" Immediately thereafter, they asked again, "Have you perfected the merit of accompanying the Tang monk?" "It's still too early. It's still too early," said Pilgrim. "With so large a distance and so many demons, we have managed to accomplish only half the merit. Right now, we are stranded in the Golden Helmet Cave of the Golden Helmet Mountain, where a bovine monster has Master Tang captured in the cave. Old Monkey found the way to his door and fought with him, but that fellow had such vast magic powers that he managed to rob Old Monkey of his golden hooped rod. That's why it is so difficult to arrest that demon king. I suspect that he has to be some evil star from the region above who has descended to earth out of longing for the world, but I really don't know what sort of demon he is or where he comes from. For this reason, Old Monkey came to seek the Jade Emperor and to charge him with the offense of not keeping his household under control. This ape head," chuckled Xu Jingyang, "is still so mischievous." "I'm not being mischievous," said Pilgrim. "It's just that Old Monkey has been inquisitive all his life, and that's how he finds things out." "No need to talk further," said Zhang Daoling. "Let's announce his arrival for him."
"Thank you. Thank you," said Pilgrim. The four celestial masters indeed went into divine mists to make the announcement and led Pilgrim to have an audience with the Jade Emperor. Bowing deeply to the throne, Pilgrim said,
"Venerable sir, I'm sorry to have troubled you. I'm sorry to have troubled you. Since Old Monkey began to accompany the Tang monk to acquire scriptures in the Western Heaven, our journey has encountered more misfortune than good luck. But that goes without saying, I suppose. Right now a bovine monster has captured the Tang monk in the Golden Helmet Cave of the Golden Helmet Mountain, and I don't know whether my master will be steamed, cooked, or sun-dried. Old Monkey found the way to his door and fought with the fiend, who seemed to recognize Old Monkey vaguely. His magic powers, however, are great indeed. He even managed to rob Old Monkey of his golden hooped rod, thus making it difficult for me to seize any monster. I have a suspicion that this monster is an evil star from heaven, who descended to the region below out of longing for the world. For this reason, Old Monkey came especially to memorialize to you. I beg the celestial worthy in his compassion to grant me my request. Please issue a decree to find out the identity of the evil star and to send troops to arrest this demon. Old Monkey makes this request with the utmost fear and trembling. Bowing deeply again, he said, "Such is my petition to be made known." On one side, Immortal Ga chuckled and said, "How is it that our ape behaves so haughtily at first and so humbly afterwards?" "How should I dare?" asked Pilgrim. "I'm not acting haughtily at first and humbly afterwards, but right now I'm a monkey who has no rod to play with." When the Jade Emperor heard this memorial, he at once gave a decree to the Kahan Bureau, saying, "In accordance with the memorial of Wukong, conduct an investigation among all the stars and planets of various heavens, and among all the divine kings of the various galaxies to see if anyone has been led to leave the region above out of longing for the world. Return to make your report as soon as you have fulfilled the decree. Such is our statement to be made known." The adept perfected Lord Kahan received the decree and went at once with the great sage to conduct this investigation. They first examined the various officials under the command of the Devarajas of the Four Heaven Gates. Next, they examined the various realized immortals, young and old, among the three forbidden enclosures. Then they checked through Tao, Zhang, Xing, Ding, Go, Bi, Pang, and Liu, the thunder deities. And finally, they searched through all 33 heavens, but no disturbance was found in any of them. They then examined the 28 lunar mansions, the seven mansions of the east containing the constellations Citra, Ni, Ya, Visakha, Anuradha, Bahu, Mulabharha I, and Purva Aedha. The seven mansions of the west containing the constellations Uttara A, Aedha, Abhijit, Srava, A, Sravi, Ha, Satabi A, Purva Pros, Apada, and Uttara Pro Hapada. What they found was that all of these mansions, including those of the North Seven Mansions and South Seven Mansions, were peaceful and quiet. They then examined the Sun, the Moon, Venus, Jupiter, Mercury, Mars, and Saturn, the seven regulators, together with Rahu, Ketu, Chi, and Bo, the four stars of excesses. Of all the stars and planets in heaven, there was not a single one who left for the region below out of longing for the world. "Since this is the case," said Pilgrim, "Old Monkey has no need to return to the Hall of Divine Mists. After all, it's not good to disturb the Jade Emperor once again. You may go back to make your report, and I'll wait here to see if there is any further message for me." The adept perfected Lord Kahan agreed. As Pilgrim Son waited there, he composed a poem to record his impressions. The poem says, "Clear wind and fair clouds make felicity. Quiet gods and bright stars show propitious signs. The cosmos at peace, earth and heaven prosper. At all five quarters arms and banners recline." After having made a thorough search everywhere, the adept perfected Lord and Master of the Kahan Bureau returned to report to the Jade Emperor with this memorial. "None is missing among the stars and mansions of heaven. The divine warriors of all quarters are present. There is no one who has left for the region below out of longing for the world." When the Jade Emperor heard this, he gave the order, "Let Wukong select a few celestial warriors to help him to capture the demon in the region below." The four celestial masters, having received this decree, went out of the treasure hall of divine mists and said to Pilgrim, "O great sage, since there is no god in the celestial palace who longs for the world, the Jade Emperor in his great mercy has asked you to select a few divine warriors instead to help you capture the demon." Bowing his head, Pilgrim thought to himself, "Those warriors in heaven whose abilities are not as good as Old Monkey's are plentiful, but those just as good are few. Remember when I caused great havoc in the celestial palace, The Jade Emperor sent out 100,000 heaven soldiers with cosmic nets, but there is not a single person who could stand up to me. They found my match only when they called up the little sage Erlang. Now this fiend has abilities as strong as old monkeys. How could we prevail against him? Perceiving the meaning of his silence, Xu Jingyang said. This time is not quite the same as last time. As the proverb says, one thing will vanquish specifically another. You can't quite disobey the decree, can you? Use your judgment and select your celestial warriors. Don't allow your hesitation to cause unnecessary blunder. In that case, said Pilgrim, I am grateful for the imperial favor. Indeed, I do not want to disobey the decree, nor does Old Monkey wish to make this trip in vain. Let me trouble Jingyang to report to the Jade Emperor that I would like to be accompanied by Devaraja Li, the Pagoda Bearer, and Prince Na, eh? They have quite a few weapons designed to capture fiends. Let us go down below to do battle once with that fiend and see how things stand. If we manage to capture him, it will be the luck of Old Monkey. If not, we can then decide what to do next.